Hello and welcome to the learning video on flipped classroom implementation. Today we are going to talk about the in-class activity that needs to be performed under flipped classroom. I am Dr. Payal Dande from SVKM's NMIMS School of Pharmacy and Technology Management, Shirpur Campus. Let's have a quick look to learning objectives. After watching this video, you should be able to understand what do we mean by in-class activities under flipped classroom. What needs to be done in such activities, and we will also try to see one of the major active learning strategy known as think, pair, share by actually doing it. So you all are now aware of the concept of flipped classroom, which has two parts. One is out of class and the other is in class. In our last learning videos, we have already discussed the activities that needs to be carried in out of class or under flipped classroom. Today we are going to talk about the in-class activity. Under in-class activity, this is the time when the teacher and the students are together inside the class. So this means the activities that are carried during the class, those are called as in-class activity. Let us see what are the activities that can be carried in-class under flipped classroom. So there could be various active learning strategies which a teacher or an instructor can use in order to elicit the higher cognitive skills in the students. So there are problem solving activities, group discussion, debate, brainstorming sessions, team pair solo approach, think pair share, predict observe explain. So these are some of the active learning strategies which I have mentioned over here. There are many more. Now, which particular learning strategy should you select totally depends upon the content which you have to take up in the class. Now, let us start by doing one of the active learning strategy. Let us learn by doing it. There are few important instructions before we move on. Please follow the instructions clearly when those which are given in the slides. And do stick to the time which is being said or which is being given in the slide. Participate and contribute to create learning. The first phase is think phase, where you have to perform this particular activity individually. You get 1 to 2 minutes for solving this. You have to enlist, you have to write any 3 advantages and limitations of flipped classroom after going through all the learning videos which we have posted in this module. So you get 1 to 2 minutes. Assuming that you have already seen the learning videos on flipped classroom, now you should be able to enlist 3 advantages and limitations of it. Hope you have done the activity. Now let's move on to the next phase. And the next phase is pair phase. Now over here, you are expected to share your learning with your partner. So you have to assemble all your answers together and now discuss and justify each answer. So why do you think particular statement is an advantage, or why do you think particular answer is a limitation of flipped classroom? After doing this, write all the overall learning made from the discussion in the pair phase. So you get 5 minutes for this particular activity. Hope you have done this. Now let's move on to the next phase, that is share phase. Under share phase, you are expected to share your learning with the group members. So now you have to come up with all your answers with correct justifications. And I as an instructor can actually enlist all the learning that was made and the queries can be resolved further. Now let us see what exactly we have done using this think, pair, share. So let us see the first phase, that is think phase. What happened in think phase? I as a teacher or an instructor posed a question to you, asked you to think individually, and then maybe as a teacher, if this would have been a scenario of class, I was expected to move around to see if someone has query, solve their query and help them put their thoughts into words. As a learner, you were expected to think on the posed question and write your answers individually in the book. Now, what have we learned out of it? So what are the deliverables of such phase? The learners actually are trying to recall. So you actually tried to recall all the learning videos which you have seen earlier and then applied your knowledge to write the learnings made. That means the advantages and limitations which were asked. So it helped to strengthen your recall and understanding level onto the concept of flipped classroom. Now what happened in pair phase? I as an instructor asked you to carry next activity in group, that is in pair phase, asked you to pair up with someone and then discuss the reason, the justification for your answers. While I was expected to move around in the class, if this should have been a class scenario, to check whether the students are discussing and provide clues to pair who had any doubts. Now, as a learner, you started discussing with your neighbor, discussed the learning made, tried to give justification for your answers, and finally, you wrote down all the justifications in the notebook. So basically, what have we achieved? As a learner, we started now practicing, teaching each other. So we started learning by teaching and learning by practicing it. This helped to strengthen our analytical reasoning and application skills. Now let us see what happened in share phase. Under share phase, all the learners shared their solutions to the class. And the instructor should list the answers on the board. They should carry the brainstorming session for all this learning that was made and the justifications that were provided by the students. So over here, the learner got optimum learning because there were several advantages and limitations that will come up from all the students. And this talks about the collaborative efforts. Over here, we are being able to strengthen the evaluation skills in the students. So let us now see the benefits of in-class activity under flipped classroom. We will discuss it with respect to the students. We will also discuss how the teacher helps. So students are now learning by doing it. They are utilizing the in-class time for active learning. They are not any more passive listeners. They help each other to learn. So this creates a very good academic environment inside the class. They also get assistance of teacher in solving real-time queries. So wherever the teacher was required, the teacher guided them in their queries, in their questions, in their doubts. This also helped to build reasoning and application skills. They started learning to work in team, debate with each other and evaluate each answer. They were able to gain optimum learning and explore the new perspectives which they must not have thought about. So overall, it enhanced all six levels rather, not only higher cognitive skills, but all six levels of Bloom's taxonomy, which we have discussed earlier. Now let us see what was the role that was played by teacher. The teacher acted as a guide on side rather than sage on stage. He or she spent more time supporting students solve their queries and less time in managing noise or behavior because that didn't come out. The time was actually being utilized to build the analytical and application skills within the students, and also it enhanced the reasoning ability within the students. Overall, the teacher was assisting the students by making them do it by themselves. So here we end up with the details of flipped classroom. I have got a very nice quote which I have been using it several times, and it helps and motivate me a lot. Give a man a fish and you feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish and you feed him for a lifetime. How true this is. But there is an addition which came from this freelearningtools.org which suggests create a good tutorial and the fish can learn by themselves. So this is what exactly we have done. We have created the learning videos for all of you to learn by yourself. A very important sincere acknowledgement to the organizers of FDP 301X, especially Patak sir and his team from IIT Bombay, who have helped us to learn all this and today made us capable of teaching others. For any queries or suggestions, you can mail it at pyle.dande@gmail.com. Thank you so much. Who dares to teach must never cease to learn. So happy learning.